Welcome to NXT POV. I'm WWE.com editor John Clapp. And these are my picks for the best matches in NXT TV history. We all know NXT is awesome. It's an embarrassment of riches. Even removing takeovers from the equation, there's a new instant classic every week. But with such a high volume of fantastic matches, where do you even begin? I would start with a match between two wrestling geniuses, Cassius Ohno and William Regal. In 2013, Ohno thought Regal had lost his edge, but keep in mind that Ohno also emulated Regal, he looked up to him. So that adds a whole different layer to this match. But while Ohno thought his lordship had lost his ruthlessness, Regal knew better, and he proved it. Because what ensued was a masterclass in wrestling, which everyone would expect, but the brutality is insane. Regal is multitasking while he's beating down Ohno. Sure, he's armbarring him in one spot, but with his other hand, he's clawing at his face. Everything is proficient and efficient, complete poise, but it's disgusting. It's a gross match almost. Regal mangles Ohno's fingers.
Oh my goodness.
But Ohno is a sicko here too. It's not just Regal. Ohno goes after Regal's equilibrium, his temple, his eardrum, with knees and kicks. He's trying to bludgeon this guy.
William Regal right now, his equilibrium's gotta be completely thrown off.
After a near fall, Regal sits up and he has this like 1,000-yard stare in his face, and it's haunting. There's plenty of nuance hidden within the brutality, but who am I kidding? This is a methodical, vicious match. It's exactly what you want from two guys who know a million ways to hurt people. The 2 out of 3 falls match between Sami Zayn and Cesaro laid the groundwork for what NXT is today. One of the first things you notice is this crazy pace that it starts out. Before the bell even rings, before the match starts, Zayn leaps over the top rope with a tope con hilo, wipes out Cesaro. The very first move after the bell is the Huluva kick.
Ooh, look at this, the cover, no! Oh wow, the early fall!
Zayn hits this DDT through the turnbuckles on the floor, I think for the first time ever on NXT TV. When you see it for the first time, it causes you to rethink everything you thought you knew about wrestling. And then you have Cesaro, who's in full beast mode.
Off the apron, whoa!
He trashes Zayn with a powerbomb, he deadlifts him like a sack of Yukon Gold potatoes. So toward the end, Zayn goes for this crazy rope walk DDT and Cesaro reverses it. But then time stands still. He holds him up there and you don't know if he's going to chuck him out of the ring. You don't know if both men are going to tumble to the floor. But then you remember, oh yeah, Cesaro's the Swiss cyborg. This man's inhuman. He throws up Zayn in the air and it is one of the craziest, if not the craziest uppercut you'll ever see. This is the match that set the tone for what NXT would become. So sometimes you don't need vendettas or rivalries for a match to be really cool. Sometimes you just want two guys who love to fight, and that's what you get in Oney Lorcan and Drew McIntyre. This is Drew McIntyre's first match back in WWE after a couple years, and he comes back as a new person. He's transformed. He returns this hulking beast of a man. Then you have Oney Lorcan, this plucky up-and-comer who knows a good showing against McIntyre will do wonders for his career. He's a complete madman. He throws himself around with reckless abandon. He hurls his entire body, his entire force into every single move, every single strike.
Oh! Lorcan dives back inside. We have got a fight here on NXT. Can Drew McIntyre get back in this thing?
McIntyre, meanwhile, is almost superhuman. By the time he catches Oney Lorcan falling out of the air from the top rope, slams him onto the ring apron, the days of 3MB are a distant memory. At one point, McIntyre uncorks his headbutt and just wallops Lorcan. There's nothing pretentious about this match. It's brawn versus scrappiness. And this is definitely a hot take for this list. A lot of people would say it was too one-sided. They would point out the fact that it only goes about 5 minutes. But if you haven't seen it in a while, watch it. It's 5 minutes of total mayhem. Asuka and Nikki Cross's last woman standing match summed up in 2 words, danger and suspense. You have Nikki Cross, who's at her most chaotic. She's draped in black and gray. She's unpredictable. She seems to thrive off pain. And then you have Asuka, who's dominant, precise, brightly colored, and in the middle of her historic run. But the last woman standing stipulation puts it over the top. You can see both women enjoy the lawlessness of it all. Asuka gets this twinkle in her eye when she pulls out a trash can for the first time. Nikki Cross is laughing through half this match. When most people would be crying, she's laughing. Now, the objective of the match is to keep your opponent down for a 10 count. And that's where the suspense comes in. They're doing everything they can. They keep having to raise the stakes higher and higher. No matter what they throw at each other, neither woman stays down. Whether Asuka rips Nikki Cross off the top onto a pile of steel chairs, or Nikki Cross hits Asuka with the Purge 4 times in a row, neither woman is quitting. This is a crazy match, and it's well worth revisiting. The last match I want to talk about today is a championship rematch between Mustache Mountain and Undisputed Era. It's tag team wrestling at its finest, but it's also the emotion. It's as emotional as any match you'll ever see. It starts with this brawl, but during the brawl, Trent Seven hurts his knee. And that's where you see Kyle O'Reilly and Roderick Strong take over like sharks in the water. They smell the blood. When you think you can't stand it any longer, Bate finally tags in, and there's an eruption. Pure elation.
He comes out of the bank! Bank runs over Strong! Wipes out O'Reilly! The much-needed tag made Tyler!
Whoa!
Towering back body drop!
It's a cathartic experience. Everybody is happy, except for probably Roderick Strong and Kyle O'Reilly.
Unbelievable offense from Tyler Bate, leaping off the turnbuckle with a European uppercut. Standing shooting star press. Tyler Bate almost retaining the tag team titles.
Trent Seven ends up tagging back in the match, and then he gets back in the same situation as before. O'Reilly hooks on a heel hook. There's no escaping, and that's where the emotion really starts to drain you. You can feel Tyler Bates contemplating, wrestling with this inner struggle of whether or not he should throw in the towel. Now, throwing in the towel, that would sacrifice the NXT tag team titles that they worked so hard to win, but in doing so, it would also protect and secure the well-being and the health of his partner, Trent Seven. There's friendship, there's valor. It's tremendously compelling to watch. So there you have it, my picks for the 5 best matches ever on NXT TV. Is it perfect? Well, no, but it's my point of view. Now give us yours. Share your favorite NXT TV matches on Twitter using hashtag NXTPOV.